the work that we do. But I, you know, I can't say no when Anvesan Foundation reaches out for anything. It's something that's very close to our hearts. So I will just share a few thoughts to begin with. And then, of course, whatever questions you have, I'm happy to take them. I know you've been having a series of mentorship programs where you must have learned a lot about valuation, pitching, fundraising, how to get your you know, art of presentation, policy reform. There's a lot of knowledge that you would have already been receiving as part of these series of mentoring sessions. So I want to talk about a very different topic today, because many times in my journey, I have found that this has been highly ignored or undervalued in the kind of impact that it can have, which is about how to actually be part of the community and to use that community, that network, to your advantage. So let me start by giving you a small introduction or a background about why I personally feel and why I went into this line to be able to create this ecosystem. Just a quick note about myself. I completed my graduation in 1991. So yes, I'm really old compared to all of you startups here. But when I completed my graduation in 91, I straight away went into entrepreneurship. At that time, there was absolutely no concept of, you know, entrepreneurship or networking or these incubators, or even the fact, I didn't even know that I could call myself a startup, because really that was not the culture at that time. All I knew was that I was doing business, you know. And I belong to, I've been born and brought up in Lucknow, which is relatively a smaller town compared to Delhi and a little more conservative in its culture. So you can well imagine a 21-year-old girl straight out of college, no experience, starts running a business. It was in the field of computers, computer peripherals, and many such allied services, because that was one of the new and growing things at that time. But if you visualize the time at then, there really was no network, no community to be a part of. All I was doing was trying to struggle to make it on my own by way of reaching out to all kinds of friends and family to whom I could go and sell my products and services. And I faced every kind of challenge that you can potentially imagine, right from trying to get money as funding, or even just collecting payments from the customers, providing customer service, having no idea about how to do marketing, etc. Because at that time, you know, very different from the environment now, there was no internet, you know, in the way that we have internet now. So bandwidth and all of that was a luxury, really, mobile phones, etc. So, you know, from my own team, my own manager and staff trying to swindle me of money, or to try and sort of take off some part of my business, to be able to get, you know, threats on the phone about saying that, you know, don't come to us for payment, otherwise we will have you kidnapped on the street. You know, all that kind of experience that one has gone through without really having anybody to lean on by way of getting advice, or, you know, a sort of a protective net around you who can help you, senior people. The only people I could reach out or lean on were relatives who were older, who were senior, who were either running a business themselves in Delhi, or were in some other part of the country running successful companies, etc. So one would reach out to them and say, you know, how do I reach out to somebody, or how do I collect my payment? I'm not getting this contract, I'm not getting this payment. So all I had was a network of, let's say, friends and family who, when they would see my struggle, would reach out and try and help. Or if I reached out to them for some guidance or assistance, they would obviously give me tips and advice. And in about 5 years of running that business, typical to what happens normally to a lot of young girls or young women entrepreneurs, is you have to eventually exit from it because you end up getting married and you move to another city and there's no way for us to run our business from another city, and therefore you fold it up and exit out of it. From that, when I, after a few years, when I came to Delhi and I came to know about an organization called TAI, which was, started in Silicon Valley with the simple intention, the single-minded intention of providing support to entrepreneurs to help create successful entrepreneurs, because the basic philosophy was that every startup, every successful startup will create jobs, will create wealth and employment for a nation, which is why this group of successful people from the Indian diaspora who had gone and settled in the US, they had struggled as well because there was no community to support them. But they came together to say, from our collective experience, can we provide just knowledge sharing, just mentorship, maybe some seed stage funding if it is required, just connections that can help the younger generation that is now following in our footsteps as well. And that organization was coming to India around that time in 2001 when I was in Delhi. And, it made me realize that that is exactly what is needed by young startups. If you can have a set of people who can be your advisors, who you can learn from, who you can reach out to, I think that seemed like something that I had missed personally in my journey to such a great extent. And I had struggled so much for those 5 years. I won't take away anything from those 5 years because the amount of learnings that I had, or the ups and downs that I saw, the amount of strength that it gave me, or the ability to really understand the character of people and, all of that. So it was a great learning experience, but it was a great struggle as well. So when an organization like TAI came into being with a single-minded objective of saying, how can we build more programs where we are able to share our learnings and help other entrepreneurs to be able to not make the same mistakes, I felt that this is exactly where I belong, because this is a great service to the nation. It's a great service to the startup community to be able to build something like that. And I have been involved with TAI ever since then, since 2001. And I have seen it grow. I have seen the startup ecosystem grow along with it. And I just want to, make sure that you realize that it's a very powerful thing to be part of a community, because entrepreneurship is difficult. Each one of you is going through it and realizes how difficult it is, what the challenges are. But it does not have to be as difficult as it was earlier. There are ways in which you can actually take advantage of the community. And, there are two schools of thought. One school of thought will say entrepreneurship cannot be taught. It is innate, it is part of, the mindset, the innate DNA of a person, whether you can be an entrepreneur or not. Whereas what are we doing? All these series of programs, all the sessions that we have, the online and offline content that is created for entrepreneurship, we are teaching entrepreneurship. In the same way, there is a school of thought which says networking cannot be taught, because it's again, a person is an introvert or an extrovert, and therefore some people are good networkers, some people are great networkers, and some people just cannot network. I was one of them who could not network or feel comfortable networking, and I still often don't. And yet I'm part of one of the most networked organizations of the world, I would say, So it's very contrary to the innate nature of being on my own versus really running an organization that thrives on networking. And one of the pillars of TAI is networking along with mentoring and education, etc. So, there are simple tips and simple tricks that you can use which will help you use this community, this network better. And I think that's what I just want to leave those thoughts with you. And then, of course, if you want to know more, I'll be able to, hopefully answer some of those questions. So I think the important thing is that where you are today is, and I don't mean necessarily this pandemic duration, I mean overall compared to the journey of the last few years, this was the time when it was the best time to be a startup, because you had a government that was talking about providing all kinds of support to the startup ecosystem, creating programs, creating opportunities for academic institutions to set up incubators. And these incubators provide such incredible support. They try and understand the needs of an entrepreneur. They give the sort of fertile ground where you can actually test your idea out. And as a young entrepreneur, that's what you need, somebody to believe in your idea and to give you that opportunity to nurture it. There is a whole community out there of peers, you know, a lot of, while Thai, of course, was started on the, you know, Guru Shishya tradition, so the mentorship concept. What we are doing today, people who you think have been there, done that, who come and share their experiences. So you will make a lot of mistakes in your journey, but at least you can avoid the same mistakes that some of the other, you know, mentors have made and are willing to share their experience. But apart from that mentor concept of senior entrepreneurs who share their experiences, what is very powerful today through the whole incubator and other, you know, events network is a community of peers, people who think like you, who are like-minded, who want to do something new, who want to create something new, who want to solve a problem in society, and who are going through the same kind of challenges that you are going through today. So they understand and they can share their experience. And, you know, as we see with a lot of young entrepreneurs who are coming out of colleges to become startup founders, they don't necessarily want to learn from people who set up successful companies 40, 50 years ago. They want to learn from new guys. They want to know how Naukri.com was set up, or how Paytm came up, how did Wow Momos or Beer Cafe, you know, these new, somebody who has done it in the last 5 to 10 years, they want to learn from that. So this peer community is, again, something very, very useful for you to lean on and take advantage of. When you are part of a community of people or a network of people, you also learn from your competitors, because there are people in the market who are doing similar or, you know, somewhat similar businesses. So you actually get a sense of what are they doing, what's working from them, what's not working from them. There's a whole set of community of influencers who can become your brand ambassadors at the end of the day. And, you know, for somebody who is really senior, respected in the industry, to just pick up the phone and call somebody else and say, hey, you know, I met a great guy and he's running a, you know, fairly interesting startup. Why don't you meet this founder, you know? To have an influencer like that in your corner who is able to make that introduction for you, I think that can open so many doors that we sometimes don't realize. And it may not be today. You may meet somebody today, but you may find benefit of that 6 months down the line also. But that influencer community is something that really is part of this community, this network that you should take advantage of. Of course, you will get access to talent, people who can potentially add complementary skills to your venture, whether as co-founders or CTOs or people you can hire as developers. So there's a whole community of people that is looking to collaborate, that is, you know, potentially for you a hunting ground for great talent to get on board, set of advisors that you can reach out to. Corporate community, you know, I heard earlier that you have just had a session on, you know, making corporate connects. I think that is something that is very active today. Every corporate is realizing that if they don't connect with startups, if they don't connect with the innovative mindset of startups, they will somewhere miss the bus. So they are all very keen to connect. Policymakers, all of that is, of course, there. And who can forget the whole investor community? Because at the end of the day, each startup will try and reach out to investors. So there is this whole network, what we call, you know, for lack of a better word, we end up using the word ecosystem a lot. They are all part of this startup ecosystem. But there are certain things that, you know, in our journey we have realized, which I would like to just mention, because many times we end up, you know, sort of catching the rabbit from the wrong end of the tail, which is to say that we try and we try and get to this community or try and take advantage of this network only when we need them for funding, for example. What we don't do is actually make use of this community early on. We try and focus so much on building our product or focusing on our business that we ignore the network, we ignore the community completely, and we only go out when we think we need to go and exchange a business card to reach out for funding. And that really is not the right way to take advantage of this network. What you have to do here is to build relationships, what one would call a circle of trust. Even if you look at yourself as an individual, you try and, you know, work with people who you can trust, who you can have a relationship. The first circle of trust of friends, family that you will create, the support that network that you create around yourselves, etc. So that circle of trust is very important, of who you can trust, and more importantly, building a network of people who can trust you. Because at the end of the day, you end up working with those people only. You end up, you must have heard so many investors in their talks, they will say that they actually focus on who the founder is, because they are not really investing in the idea or the execution at the moment. They're looking at the people. They're looking at the team in a startup that is running that venture, because they make their bet on the people that are there. So for you to build a relationship and eventually work with those people is very important for you to do at an early stage. If you reach out to them only at the stage when you want to sell something to somebody, or you want to, you know, get them to invest in you, it will not be a very successful transaction. You have to invest, you know, while you focus on your product, your pricing, your market, you have to give equal importance to the fact that there is a community and a network that you need to build. For that, first you have to build the network. So identify the networks that you think are going to be useful for you. After you have identified that network, take the trouble, and nobody in your team can do this, this really rests with the founder, to be able to go out there and be part of this community with a very selfless, you know, sort of a mindset. Because if you go there with the intention of taking or getting something out of it, people get that vibe. You know, I don't want to be surrounded by people who are trying to get or take something from me. I want to be surrounded first by people who I feel interested in, who I feel are here to make a difference, or genuinely are interested in knowing what I do, what I can offer, how we can then work together comes later. So I think that is something that we have to do, is that in our community or network discussions, not make it so transactional that the only thing we are doing is going to an event to just exchange business cards and come back home and say, I today collected 30 cards and, you know, that's a great day for me. Because what you have to do is to leave an impression on the mind of the person that you meet. And that is not by exchanging just a business card. You have to be able to tell them about yourself, get them interested in who you are, show interest in what they are doing, you know, find out more about them, and then let the relationship evolve a few months down the line when they feel that, you know, they can connect you to somebody, or they feel that they want to get back in touch with you, or later when you feel you want to reach out to them for funding, then you're not going there just as a simple startup that's going to pitch them, but you're going to somebody who has almost become part of your circle of trust, part of your friends or relationship network. So it's almost like a daily priority that I would say that you have to build into that in a very and even if you're not comfortable networking, you have to take the trouble of letting people know about yourself and learning more and more about them. Because when you get to know more about people, you will also be able to realize how they can help you later. And the other thing is, you know, we end up meeting so many people, but very often 2 months down the line, we won't remember them. We won't remember whose card it was, what that person that did. So I think it's also equally important to use a process in which you not only meet the right people, but also be able to categorize them, to say who does what? What did I need them for? What did they tell me about themselves? And later, when I need to reflect back on that, then I can actually go back and see who were these people and how do I reach out to them. And the second thing is also, if out of those 30 people that you met, you feel that there were five who you think will be useful for you later, then build a relationship. Try and find opportunities to connect with them off and on, so that they also remember you, they recall you, and you don't just do a cold calling 3 months down the line. So, you know, almost like a science, pick on it, strategize on when, how, what kind of communication will you have with this community of people, at what periodicity will you do that. And, you know, there's often a saying that it doesn't matter what you know, it matters who you know to some extent. So you have to build that roster early on of developing this very selfless-minded networking skill in the community, because there is a community of people out there to help you. This is what we are doing today is exactly part of that. What the incubator is offering you is that opportunity. But for you to be able to go out of your comfort zone and say, how can I, you know, be part of this community? What are the ways in which I can sort of not only just benefit from it, but also give back to the community? Because, you know, it's the circle of life is always like that. So the more you give, the more you receive. And that is something we have seen in these 20 years. So much that everybody who benefited from it somewhere down the line has come back to now become mentors and give back, you know, Sanjeev Bichandani, Deep Kalra, household names today with the ventures that they have created as Make My Trip, Naukri.com, etc. They benefited, they joined TIRE when they were young startups, they were starting their company, and through this process of mentorship, this process of funding, advisory roles that they got with senior entrepreneurs, they have now come back to be some of the best mentors. They devote so much time to mentorship. They have created funds where they are also investing in companies in their sector, etc. So the more you get, the more you also give back. And therefore, that's why I said it's a circle that you actually need to build on. But don't start selling from the first day itself, because that puts people off. I'm not there to buy, but if somebody is trying to sell something to me, it makes people a little hesitant in going and sort of communicating on that front. First, focus on getting to know a person, getting to know, be a part of a community, see ways in which you can offer help to others, and you will find very quickly that the universe is giving back that that help and support to you, because, you know, what people want basically are people who are credible, who they can actually depend on when they need it. But you need to be out there with your ability to interact, ability to engage with people, and we have found that, you know, very often the best way for us to actually sell products is not by selling it ourselves, but actually using a network of people who become your referrals, you know, in that sense. Because then I'm not just dependent on the five people that I met as my potential customers or my potential investors, but these are the five people who will go and tell their network about what you are doing as founders, etc. So, you know, focus on these few things in terms of taking advantage of all the organizations that are there, while there is a lockdown or a reduction in terms of the ability for people to meet and be part of events physically, but the whole virtual world has opened up. And we have seen the appetite in people to be able to actually come together as part of these online sessions much, much more than even physical sessions. We would have hosted about 100 events in the last few months, and more than 50,000 people have actually participated in them. Because it gave them a feeling that during this difficult time, they were not alone. There was a community that they were a part of. And therefore, they felt that they could go through this in a much better manner rather than just sort of going through the stress and collapsing under this. Because there were others who were going through it. There were others who were willing to share their knowledge and connect. And, you know, a lot of mentoring helplines opened and all of that was done. So it's very, very important to use this virtual world. It's almost brought the whole global community together. It's not just about what we have over here in Delhi, for example. Of course, it's a very vibrant ecosystem of startups in Delhi, but the whole global networking community has come together for startups. So I think that is something you should not hesitate to ask for help. You should not hesitate to offer help, because both these things are important. Nobody can do it alone. Startup journey is not something that can be done alone. So it's, you should be willing to ask for help. I think that's where I did not do enough of looking around and asking for right kind of help, and I struggled because of that. But at the same time, if there's somebody out there who you can help, please offer it, go out there and offer it. I think that's what I just wanted to share, that first of all, when we look at the community, identify the various networks that are available to you to help you. We have about 61 Thai chapters in 14 countries, and there is so much of collaboration, exchange of information, exchange of knowledge among members, business opportunities that are there, funding opportunities that they connect themselves for. So use many of these organizations that are there to provide that kind of assistance. Second thing I would say is, don't do it later in your journey. Focus on it from the first day of your journey. As an important part of your strategy for succeeding is to be part of a community, feel part of that community truly in the true sense of the word. Don't just go there with a mindset to sell or raise investment. First, build credibility around yourself. Try and help others as much as possible so that they feel, they also want to help you. Build a network of mentors, advisors. You will find them in your own family also, perhaps, and also, of course, in the community, your sectors that you're focusing on. And based on that, take it like a method to the madness, that it's not just about knowing more and more people. It is about knowing people in a way that you can then identify how you want to build a relationship with them, how you want to stay in touch with them. Sometimes you may find that there is a person who inspires you. Try and go through their LinkedIn, read their articles, their blogs, send them a message sometime appreciating an article. Some of those things will help you stay in touch with a person without making it transactional. And that develops in many, many ways later on when you're trying to do something. With that, I'll stop here. I'm not sure how much time we have or what is required in terms of Q&A, etc. But my simple request was, you are not alone. We are all out here to help you. We are all out here to be part of your journey. Not just us, but even senior successful entrepreneurs, because this becomes a way for them to be serial entrepreneurs, where they remain connected to new talent, new founders. Like yourself, they look at opportunities to invest. And everybody is trying to come up with more and more creative ways of creating more access to funds, creating access to business opportunities, etc. So times are hard. They will be hard. Anyway, for entrepreneurs, it's been stressful and hard always. But there are all of us around you. So you should feel that you have a friend in this community that you can be a part of. And offer your friendship to others, because that will really help you grow the community. And the bigger the community, obviously, the bigger the pie, the more everybody gets a piece of the pie. So that's what I just wanted to share. Vijay, I don't know if this is what you meant when you talked about networks and community, but happy to answer any questions or any doubts that people might have.
Thanks, Geetika. Giving more light to this, you all understand that network management is really very important, not only in making yourself comfortable, but also in your time management and in your stress management. When we talk about actually the quotients, apart from the intelligence quotient, when we talk about emotional, social, or adversity quotient, at that time also, if you are having good network, you are connected with good people, definitely good people. Those who may be helpful to you may not be helpful to you. At that particular time, it is definitely going to be a good ecosystem you are going to create for you, which will definitely ease your entrepreneurial journey towards success. This is the point which you all should understand. in the year 2000, when I was doing my MBA from Lucknow University, there was definitely a subject was there, entrepreneurship development. And one topic was there, you know, that the heading of that topic was entrepreneurial opportunity recognition. In that particular topic, there were three heads, basically ingredients, what you can say, from where you can get the essence of success in your life. One was the combination of education and experience. Second one was alertness, you know, entrepreneurial alertness. When we talk about entrepreneurial development, from entrepreneurial development, we come to know about entrepreneurial alertness so that we can recognize the right opportunity at right time, as we were discussing in the previous session. And the third one was the network management. This is what the network you are having. When we talk about the ecosystem, in ecosystem, you are there, your partners are there, your promoters definitely, your mentors are there, people who are facilitating your startup as with a job of CA or CS or IPR facilitators, or, you know, marketers, means affiliate marketers, or so many things. Apart from that, you are bound with number of tier of buyers, number of tiers of suppliers. You are also having links with bank managers to get loan. Also linked with alternate investment fund with number of investors, you know, angel investors, anchor investors, cornerstone investors, marquee institution investors, even FPIs are there. So, you know, the total combination, if you talk about, there's a complete ecosystem. And in between consultancy companies or the big bank companies, even like I, they are also there to support you at every time. So this ecosystem presently, it is 100% supportive, which was never there in the years before. When I did my engineering or my MBA or PhD, at that time, nobody knew about this and this thing about what is a startup. When I used to say that, you know, a startup, because I was taking these terms from out of India. But I am thankful to our Honorable Prime Minister that so many, you know, schemes are floated in the system. And we all are now involved in the system, directly or indirectly, we all are supporting it. So if you have any questions, please, Geetika ma'am would like to answer your questions. She is very friendly attitude and with great knowledge.
Absolutely. See, the word networking itself, I mean, it's about net. It provides a safety net to startups, but you have to make that safety net work for you. You know, so it's really about using it in the right way so that they, you can use it effectively. And you have to also, every founder needs to realize that they are not the consumers of their end product. You will be selling your, service or product, whatever you have, to others. So it's not just about building a great product at your end, because unless you are ready and willing to be out there to receive feedback, to receive any kind of, critical comments or advice about what is right or what is wrong, you will never, you know, end up sort of fine-tuning it and getting it out. Many times we find that the founders get very frustrated when they go out and they get negative feedback, because they feel they have such a great idea, they have so much passion for what they do. But they're not really open sometimes to the feedback that they get from others. And that sometimes becomes a bit of a challenge. And when I remember we were doing the startup expo, where we would have startups come and showcase themselves, etc. And 20,000 startups from across the country came there. We didn't even know so many of them. And when we finished that session, there were two young boys who had come from Meerut to attend that startup expo. And they literally had tears in their eyes, because they said, when we have come here, it's not that we found any funding or that we came here for selling our product, but simply the feedback that we have received today has made us realize that 6 months of work that we would have wasted working on this product will be saved, because the feedback that we have got today will help us fine tune it and now deliver it better to the market. So I think that itself is a very, very powerful thing, where it can help you save so much time and frustration in your journey by being able to connect with other people and share your idea and, you know, be able to give feedback to others, because you will consume somebody else's product and at the same time they will be customers for you. So that cross linkage, cross sharing of information is really important.
Thanks, Geetika. I am really elated to host your stupendous session. So I open it to the forum. If you have any question, please, you can unmute yourself by your end and please ask questions. Otherwise, also you can write your question in the chat box.
So there's one here, which is from Arjun Raj, that he is making a prescription card and reader, and the Honorable Prime Minister announced a digital health vision as same as this project. Well, then I have to say great minds think alike, Arjun, because what you have thought has also been announced, you say, from the Prime Minister's office as well. Subscription-based business project. Is there any problem with making something same as government project? We work on a prototype and are waiting for the call from Nidhi Prayas Center. I will just wish you best of luck, you know, in what you're building, and you know, hope that Nidhi Prayas Center will call you. See, the government will announce a lot of projects, a lot of schemes, but they do look for innovation. They look for startup founders who will actually run projects. So without knowing too many details about your business or how it is the same, see, the government will not be running businesses. That's not their job. They will be creating schemes, opportunities, and create organizations that will help startups connect with opportunities such as this. So I know that there are a lot of such programs that are being launched under Startup India, under Niti Aayog, etc. So perhaps it's a good idea for you to look at that. There is this Agni program that is also run under Niti Aayog, which was also focusing on healthcare as a sector. So that could be another one for you to look at. But I think remove the aspect about, let's say, the government announcing this project. Any business that founders that you are running, you will always find somebody else also doing it. There are so many ideas that people have, so many similar ideas. So you have to evaluate it in a different context. There are people who will have similar business ideas. What you are doing today, even if nobody is doing today, 5 months down the line or a year down the line, some other company might come in and do it. So you have to see what is it that makes your product or your service unique. What is it that is disruptive? Because even if you start this day and then a healthcare giant corporate comes and says, oh, this is a very smart thing, and they have huge amounts of money, they have established business model. Tomorrow, if they come and launch it, what will simply eat you up, right? So you have to think of it from the beginning, that if there is a business that you are starting, what is differentiating you from others, which is not easy for somebody else to just come and replicate and take it away. Because if that's the case, if you think it does not have that kind of a ability to protect it from competition in the future, then don't waste your time now itself. Because somewhere, you know, if it's something that's nice, somebody might come and do it. I mean, we started, let's say, an e-commerce company, but today everybody has to compete with Amazon at the end of the day. So they will all, this competition will always keep coming. Many of those will be much larger than what you are today. So focus on your project the way you think will be difficult for others to replicate, or make it so good, or make it so differentiated that they want to come and either collaborate with you or acquire your company and pay you for it, you know. So there has to be something that makes it stand apart rather than a replication of an idea.
Yeah, thank you, Geetika. Yeah, any other question, please? I think, Geetika, there is no question. If there would be any, I will definitely forward it to you.
Absolutely, absolutely. Just think about, and you know, we get a lot of, sometimes questions about the fact that, look, I am an introvert. I am not able to go and talk to people. I'm not, I can't go and, if somebody comes and talks to me, it's fine. I will talk to them. But how do I go and approach somebody and introduce myself, etc.? So I think those are things that you have to build as a skill within yourself. Initially you may find it difficult, but once you do it a few times, it breaks the barrier. And for all those who actually are introverts and like to do it from behind, this is an opportunity when you're in a lockdown and the only thing you're doing is doing it from either behind a screen or a camera, sometimes with your camera off as well. So I think use this time to be able to develop that skill to network, identify ways to do it. And there are actually people who train people to even do networking now. That has also become a business model where somebody can actually teach you to network better. But I think just take it the same way that you do it in your family. In your family, you have we're all social creatures. Everybody is missing meeting other people. So you just like to grow a baby in your family with the help of your parents, your grandparents, your support staff. So, and you lean on them for all kinds of help. Your startup is your baby. So every help that you can get for your baby, go out there and take it. They will help how to make it walk, how to make it talk, and then help them grow and get their wings to fly. So all the best to all of you. My good wishes. And anytime you need help, just let us know.
Thank you, Geetika. Thank you.
Thanks a lot for arranging this. And
thanks to all the participants. Thank you. Thanks to all the participants. Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Yeah, all the participants, thanks for attending the session. As I've already mentioned in the chat box, our next mentorship session is on 13th. Please join that. And the program which I was talking about, it is a 3-month course on innovation and entrepreneurship. So you can also ask your students and others who are linked with you and want to do something in this particular area of entrepreneurship to join that particular program. Thanks. Now I am going to end this meeting. If you have any questions, please you can ask.
So we can open the session for next 5 minutes. People are filling the feedback form. After 5 minutes, we will close.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Rahul.
All are requested to fill the feedback form, please. Link is shared in the chat box. I have posted the link again. Please see that. Any issue, you can ask me. if they have filled the feedback form and received the certificate, they can leave the meeting. We will be ending in the next 10 minutes. Please fill the feedback form.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I'm facing a problem in uploading the screenshot.
Yes, sir. Same thing here also.
Okay.
So here you mentioned now we have to upload something.
Yeah, you have to upload the screenshot, but I can see almost 20 responses with the screenshot.
No, it is only showing that the camera things have been on, but it's not showing the option of the screenshot clicks. So we have taken screenshots, so those